Welcome, everybody. Thank you for joining us today. We will wait until 7 o'clock to start properly, so feel free to grab a coffee or take a quick toilet break, and then we will start soon. So we'll see you then.
Did you stop it?
No. I will see if I can.
Hello, everyone that's joined us. We appreciate you joining. We will start at 7 o'clock, so feel free to take a quick comfort break or grab a coffee or drink or something, and we'll start at the hour. See you soon.
Hello, everybody. Welcome. Thank you for joining Argentine Tango fundraiser for A World with Friends. Yeah, really appreciate you joining this evening and hope you're going to have an amazing time. For those of you that don't know, my name is Nick and this is my dance partner, Vivian.
Hi, guys.
And today we're going to show you and teach you a bit about Argentine Tango. So the lessons over the next 3 weeks, we'll be looking at, first of all today, the basics of tango. And then in the other two lessons, we're going to be doing a choreography. So this choreography is for those of you at home to practice in your own space and in your own time, but also for any of those watching now or on the recorded session to dance at the prom that is being organized for A World with Friends. So I'm sure all of you know about the charity A World with Friends, which is set up by the amazing Lewis Hine. And it's a charity that helps connect young children that suffer with illnesses and helps bring them together and make friends. And in June next year, there will be a prom. If you're watching this closer to the time, hello. Hello again. And so in June 2022, there'll be a prom where the children, if they would like to, can practice and dance this choreography that we'll be teaching in the subsequent two lessons. But today is just an introduction to tango, an introduction to the basics to give you the foundations to move on. So we are live streaming on Facebook or on YouTube, sorry. So there can't be too much interaction between us and those of you at home, but we do have the chat function. So if you have any questions, please feel free to pop them in the chat. And we can read those and answer any questions you may have. Yeah. We'll be finishing at 8:30 today, so an hour and a half. And we have a lot packed for you, in store for you, so get ready. Just one or two final more things. Firstly, we have put the link to donate to the fundraiser for the prom, all the money has been fundraise for the description of this live stream. It's also in the description of the YouTube channel and in the description of all the other YouTube videos. If you have a dance partner, please feel free to pop onto the YouTube channel where you will see other videos that I've pre-recorded that is for those that are dancing individually. So we've come up with some exercises to make this as inclusive as possible to make sure that you feel that you are learning tango and you understand tango, but you can do it at your own pace. And even if you are dancing with someone today, feel free to go back and watch those videos and practice in your own time and really put those hours in so you can rock it on the dance floor in June. Yes, exactly. So that's it. That's it from me on announcements. So I hope you all are excited. So without further ado, we'll just jump into it. So Argentine Tango is an amazing dance. Me and Vivian have been dancing about 5 years each. And we just thoroughly loved it, or love it. I actually lived in Argentina for about 6 months and danced every day. I loved it that much. And it's such a great dance. It's actually called the Everest of social dancing because it is irresistible, demanding, intricate, and all the other things that you would associate with Mount Everest. And that is so true. It is hard. It is challenging, but it's amazing, it's beautiful, and there's so many good things and good benefits as a result of dancing Argentine Tango. Now, one slight asterisk to Argentine Tango is that it's slightly different to what you may see on Strictly. The Strictly dances are amazing, and actually our teachers do the choreography for the Argentine Tango Strictly, or the dancing of Argentine Tango on Strictly. But that is choreographed. What Argentine Tango at its heart is improvised. So as a leader, I would lead, and as a follower, Vivian would follow. And this means that you never have the same dance twice. You will be in different places, you will be with someone different, because it's improvised, you'll do different sequences, you'll do different moves, you'll be in a different mood. And I and Vivian have danced all over the world, whether that be in South America, China, all around Europe. And that, because it's a improvised dance, that's what allows us to do that, to dance with strangers almost, because it's led and followed. But what we're doing today, as I mentioned, is the basics of tango. And then in the subsequent two lessons, we will teach you a choreography which although isn't true tango, is still tango in itself, and helps you learn a bit more about the dance. So what we're going to do today is we're going to put on some songs and we're going to do some exercises, but we're also going to put on some non-tango songs so you can rock it at home to some non-tango music. So what we're going to do first is we're going to start off with walking. And if you're watching on the individual videos on the playlist, this is the first video labeled video one or video two. Actually, this is the video two. So what we would like you to do is just individually, just think about standing straight. Just think about standing upright, nothing else. So once you're there, you're relaxed, your shoulders are relaxed, your feet are all relaxed and ankles are relaxed. What I'd like you to do is think about having a rope on your abs. I know all of you have got abs back at home, so make sure you put your hands on your stomach and think about pulling a rope from the opposite ends and really growing up into that rope. Or if you'd like to think about something pulling you from the back of your head or the top of your head, think about growing. So you're really growing and you're in an upright position.
So on the side like this, instead of being, you know, how we would slouch a bit or up.
So from here, so you've thought about going upright, then would like you to think about bringing your thighs together. And to make that easier, you might like to slightly open your feet. So instead of standing your feet in two parallel tracks, bring your thighs together, ankles together, and feet slightly turned out. Not hugely, but slightly. Okay, so we are here. We have grown. Our thighs are together. And what I would like you to do is just simply rock forwards and backwards. What you'll be able to see if I go this way is that my weight is in the center. Now if I rock forwards, my weight is over my toes. If I rock backwards, my weight is over my heels. So what I'd like you to do at home, just individually, not with your partner right now, is just standing upright and rocking over your toes, rocking over your heels. Toes, heels. Thinking about keeping your thighs together. Cool. And just do that for another 5 or 10 repetitions. And feel free to do that while I'm talking as well when we're going on to the next thing. So when you're on your toes, you should be able to lift your heels up. When you're on your heels, you should be able to lift your toes up. Okay, so walking in tango is the fundamentals of the dance, and it's actually not that difficult because all it is just walking like you would do down the street.
For a man?
Well, yes, walking like you would do for a leader. So what we'll do is we'll explain the leader role first and then Vivian will explain the follower walking. But regardless of whether you're going to be leading or following today, do practice both when we're talking about it. So sometimes people walk for both followers and leaders, they walk a bit like a penguin in tango. They walk like this. But you don't walk like a penguin when you're walking down the street. Well, at least I hope you don't. So what I'd like for you to do is when we're going to be walking, it's just walking normally. So from the side, just looks like I'm walking normally. All the time, I'm thinking about keeping my thighs and my ankles together. So I step, I think about my thighs coming together, my ankles coming together, step, step, step. And that's it for a leader. So when we're walking together, when we come to dancing together, no different. So as you walk down the street, than it would be if you were dancing with a partner. I'll show you. So this is how I walk normally down the street. And then this is how I would dance with Vivian. So hopefully you can see that it's not different and it's just essentially walking. So that's for the leaders walking forwards. For the followers?
Yeah, unfortunately, we have a harder job because they're walking forward and we have to, for most of the time, walk backwards. So I wouldn't suggest that you do that while you're walking on the street. But if we think about it, it has to be as natural as possible. So we do try and stand having our axis on the middle of our feet. So not back on our heels and not forward on our toes completely. So about here. And all we have to do is try and, from being upwards, try and extend our leg. And then the leader is going to come towards us, because remember, they're coming, they're walking forward. And the minute this happens, we're just going to step back and then collect our leg. Again, the same thing happens as with the leaders. We extend. And once they place us to a position where we can close the other leg, we think heel, ankle and thighs together. So if I were to do it from the front, I would be here, they position me and I collect my leg and I don't go here or here. I just go straight in thinking that my ankle is going to meet the other ankle.
So yeah, as Vivian said, for the followers, don't just think about walking backwards like this. You extend, transfer your weight. Extend, transfer your weight. Extend and transfer. Okay, so what we're going to do now is we're going to put on a song and we're going to ask you guys to try that at home. So you can do it in a circle in whatever, however big of a space you have. And just think about walking heels together, thighs together. And you should be able to hear it when I play the music, but think about dancing on the beat as well. What Vivi and I will do is we'll clap along to the beat and think about stepping on each beat. Okay, so we'll put on a song and practice that.
Come for you, I guess you moved on really easily. Found a new girl that only took a couple weeks. Remember when you said that you wanted to give me the world? Come for you, I guess that you've been working on yourself. There's a therapist to find me if you really help. You could be a better man if you're a brand new girl.
That went okay. Does anyone have any questions? Yeah, put them in the chat if you do. Okay. So what we're going to do now is we're going to think about doing that together. So take your partner, and what we'll do is we'll do something called the practice embrace. So for me, that means my arms are underneath, Vivian's arms are on top. And from here, I'm putting my palms on her tricep area, so just below her shoulders.
Same for me. I'm doing the same, just on the upper side rather than from below.
Yeah.
So I'm here.
So now get in that position that we talked about before, growing here, thighs together, both of you. And just as before, we were going on our toes and then our heels. What I want you to think about now is going right foot, left foot. So if Vivi and I show, our weight is completely free on our left foot when we have the weight on our right foot. And if we go onto our left foot, our weight is completely free on this side. So to begin with, just want you to, as the leader, you are transferring your weight from one foot to the other. And as the follower, you should be able to feel that. If I stop, Vivian stops. If I go, Vivian goes. So have a little fun, or a little bit of fun, playing as the leader with your follower, testing whether they are doing it naturally or whether they are listening to you. So you might want to do quick ones, so quick rebounds, or slow ones. Just play with that, with your partner. Play with going from one foot to the other as the leader, and as the follower, you should be able to feel that change of weight, and you just reciprocate it.
Mirror them.
You mirror them, exactly.
So if Nick's free leg is the left one, for us it's the right one, because we're mirroring them, right?
Yep, and then the other side, same the other side. Okay, so I'll give you 30 more seconds, just practice that. Your feet stay in exactly the same place. That's one thing that is quite important. We're not changing our weight and going stepping, stepping. We are changing our weight, but our feet remain in the same place.
And we're not changing our pelvis either.
We're changing the axis. We call it in Tango, we call it the axis. We're putting our axis over our one side of our body. And this is where the growing here is essential. Because if you do it now, do it with me. If you just bend over excessively and then try and change weight, you lose your balance almost straight away. But if you're upright, then it's a lot easier. You're a lot more in control. Okay, so this is where the walking begins. So we'll go back to the embrace, the practice embrace with your partner. And as we transfer weight from one side to the other, so as a leader, once our weight is on one foot, so my weight is on my right, Vivian's on her left, I'm going to give her an intention to walk. And this is quite a difficult thing to explain online. But what it essentially is I'm basically saying to Vivian, please go there with my body. I'm not pushing her with my arms. I'm saying, I'd like you to go there, please. So as my whole body is coming, and I'm like, are you ready to step, Vivian? And Vivian might be like, no, I'm not. But hopefully she's like, yes, I am. And that's how we begin the walk. So we're on one leg, and then here, as the leader, I give the intention. And this, you'll see, is where we talked about. Well, if you just keep your leg there. Yeah. So this is exactly the same place that the followers were in when they were walking backwards just 5 minutes ago, 10 minutes ago. And it's the same with the other leg. If I give the intention, Vivian is in that exact position that she was before that allowed her to step. But all the difference now is that I'm going to step with her. So we're transferring our weight. And then I give an intention for her. And then I step where her foot was. I push off of my back foot and we come together. So we'll do it the same on the other side. So I'm transferring from one side to the other.
I give the intention to go, I then go, I push off, and we collect. And this speed, that's it very slowed down and broken up. This is how it looks like when it's a bit faster. Well, I give the intention, I walk. Intention, I walk. Intention, and I walk. So make sure that you're always giving that intention first as a leader. You give the intention, you collect. You then give another intention, you collect. You give another intention, and you collect. Okay, so have a go at that now. And this time we'll put on a tango song, and you can have a go practicing that. So feel free to just start with doing one step. So we've transferred our weight, we've given the intention, we step, we collect. That's fine, that's a really good first start. And then second of all, have a try at doing continuous steps. And the walking is exactly the same as we were doing separately. When I was going, just walking like down the street normally, that's exactly the same. And for Vivian, it's exactly the same as well. She extends, transfers her weight, collects. Okay. Okay, I hope that went well. I hope everyone understood and didn't have too many troubles. And don't worry, if, as I mentioned in the beginning, if you're not a fan of tango music, we'll be reverting back to pop songs consecutively. So any questions, put them in the chat if you do.
I just want to make sure I can see the chat. So bear with me 2 minutes. Okay, yeah, I can. Okay, well, if anyone has any questions, feel free to drop me in.
So what we'll do now is we're going to do something called forward otros. So we've done walking, and tango is essentially walking, just walking in lots of different directions and using something called pivots to change the direction that we're able to walk. So in tango, we normally, as a leader, step forward, and as a follower, step backwards. But unless you're dancing in a field and have endless amounts of space, which I hope you're not on a late November night, but some of you may have found when you were practicing then that you got to an end of the room and then you're like, oh shoot, I can't go anywhere. So this is how we, in tango, we use pivots to prevent that from happening and to help us get out of that scenario. So through pivots, we create something we've called an otro. Now, normally I would ask anyone if anyone speaks Spanish, but as I can't interact with you, I will presume that you all speak Spanish. So you will all know what ocho means in Spanish, but ocho is eight, for those of you that don't remember. So ocho is eight, and this is because we create a figure eight on the floor with our feet. So what this looks like before we break it down is, if we do it together, is we are creating figures of eight on the floor with our feet. Hopefully you can all see that at home. So, how is it done? Well, first of all, I would like you, regardless of whether you're an individual or dancing as a pair, to take a wall. Mm-hmm. You should all, again, unless you're dancing in a field, have some form of wall near
or
you.
Chair.
Or chair. And we're going to be using that quickly for the next exercise. So for those of you with the individual videos, this is video three. So what we're going to be doing now is using the wall to help us with the ochos. So this is my wall. Okay, so imagine this is my wall. So imagine that I am like here at home. And what we're going to be doing is, with our wall, we're going to keep our chest facing to the wall. We're then going to do all the things that we've talked about already. We grow here, thighs together, ankles together, rocking from left to right. And then, once your weight is on your left foot, I want you to pivot. So my right leg is free. I want you to pivot to the left while keeping your chest and your hands on the wall. So your chest is facing the wall, but then your feet and should be now facing left. It should be at 90 degrees-ish angle, but my right foot is still free. And then from here, along the wall, just step like you would normally. So just as where we were earlier when we were going one direction, we stepped. No different, but now our chest is facing the wall. We then push off. So our weight is on our right leg now. We collect our feet. We don't change our weight. We collect our feet. And then we go 180. So from the first position we were just at, we come 180 degrees, so our feet are now going right. And then we repeat. So we step, we push off, we collect our feet, and we do another 180. And then we can do this continuously. So, you want to see that in the background when I explain. So, this is hard, don't get me wrong, it is hard, but this is why we're using the wall. Use the wall to support you as you step. So you're facing the wall, your weight is on the wall, you are then completely doing 180 without putting your foot down and stepping again. What happens a lot of the time is that people do this amazing, they start off amazing, so they've transferred their weight, they've gone, so this is the wall, they've gone here, they turn a bit, and they transfer their weight, and then they kind of come round. Now, I know it's difficult, and as I said, that's why we're doing it against the wall, but think about trying to keep your leg off the ground. I'll over-exaggerate, but my leg is completely off the ground when I turn. Again, here. My leg is completely off the ground and I come around 180. So now, not exaggerating, it looks a lot nicer. So if you look down while you're doing it, you should be able to see that you're creating a figure of eight on the floor. Okay, so I'm going to put another song, and just individually, and then we'll come to doing it together. Have a go at doing that, those ochos against the wall. So just one quick reminder, you're up against your wall, your thighs are together, you've grown here, we're transferring your weight, we're going to start going to the left. Our chest is still facing the wall, and then we step and we go into our ochos. Cool. Okay, well, I'm going to put on a song and I'll come to that. So I'm not going to stop it for too long. Now I know that this is hard if you haven't got a slippery floor. So if you have got shoes and you're on carpet, try in socks. That should help. Now I'm going to count. I'll let the song play, but start in different directions. So we just started on our left foot, and then we turned left, and we started, and we went into it. Now start on your right foot, and we turn right. Go into it. So exactly the same. You just start seeing from different directions, but then you do exactly the same move. And this is why I love tango, and I know Vivian loves tango as well, because you can do a million different things in a million different ways. I'll let some play because I like it, and I'll shut up. And you can practice that. Energy, I see it's written in the sky. Thinking I'm wherever, so it's going now. I know that baby, no one's ever had it too far. Glitter in the sky, glitter in the heart, it shines the way. I feel it particular every time I get to kill it, but whatever, it's gonna cost a lot. You want me, I want you to get home. I'm unstoppable, I'm unhesitating. I'm not you in, we're gonna get it. Yeah. I got you, roll up. Forward ochos, and as I said, it's forward ochos because if you look down, you should be creating a figure eight on the floor with your feet.
Moving forward.
So one thing I forgot to mention when doing the walking, and the same applies in the ochos, is we don't need to be taking huge steps. And that applies when I'm walking with Vivian as well. I don't need to be going, I just walk normally. Just completely walk normally, take the normal size steps. If I'm walking down the street, right, people don't look at me and go, wow, he's looking, walking like a weirdo, don't they? Because, well, sometimes I might, sometimes people might say that, but that's not to do with my walking. They just walk normally. And that's exactly the same in tango. So whether we're walking or we're doing the ochos, I'm taking a normal size step. I'm not doing a little one and going, I'm taking normal steps. Okay? So what we're going to do now is just to recap and re-jog your memory before we get that back to doing ochos together, is I'm going to put on a song and I want you to dance with your partner just walking around the room again. So don't worry about ochos, we'll come back to that in about 2 minutes. But just to jog your memory, we're together in this embrace. And then, actually, no, you know what? Because we're going to do the ochos, we'll do the tango embrace now. So you're going to, the leader, left hand, or you put the follower's right palm in the leader's left hand. And then as a leader, my hand goes on her back. So here. And as a follower,
my hand is touching his arm here, right? So we don't need any gaps. And then going up to his shoulder.
Not your back blade. Your back blade. Yeah.
Not here?
No.
Here.
Yeah. So we have lots of points of connection. We have here. We have here,
this bit here,
and then we have our palms. If you would like to, later on, we can dance chest to chest. So we can dance chest to chest. But right now, keep it open.
Mm-hmm.
So there's a gap here
between us.
And that's it. So now, just go back to walking, but in that embrace. So to run through the list again, right palm of the follower and the left palm of the leader. You've got the connections on the right-hand side of the embrace. I, as a leader, am transferring my weight. I give an intention for the follower to step. I step. And then we collect. And then we do that continuously. So we walk around the room and I give intention, I step, I give intention, I step, I give intention, I step, I give intention, I step. And for those of you who are born natural tango dancers, which I know that all of you are, you can use and try and think about how to, or you can think about how to use the pivots that we just did to get out of difficult situations I mentioned earlier. So just then, I'm in a difficult situation. What am I going to do? Now, I'm not going to tell you the answer because that's what we're going to do next, but have a think when you're walking around the room, redrawing your memory about how to just walk. So yeah, just walking for the next song.
Thank you.
Jogged your memory of how to walk and how to use the embrace and the intention before stepping. Because just think about it, if I don't give Vivian the intention first and then I step as a leader, I'm going to step on her poor toes. Show you. We're here and I'm going to walk now and I don't ask her to walk first. I'm stepping on her toes. So I have to give the intention, and then I go. So now we're going to do the ochos in the tango embrace. So we get into the tango embrace again. And we, as a leader, we change our weight just as we were doing in the ochos before. Now this is where life becomes very easy. For a leader, less so for a follower. Because a leader, we're actually not going to do any ochos. The follower's going to do them. So we're transferring our weight, and then we are on our left side. So a leader on our left, and the follower as their right. Mm-hmm. And then just as I had to invite Vivian to step backwards, I'm now going to imagine I've got a big rock as a leader and I'm trying to move it to my left.
Thank you very much.
So I'm holding something and I'm letting it go to my left. And this is where, so I'm the wall as the leader, that when we were practicing individually, I'm the wall. And now Vivian's ready to do the ocho. So now we can step together. From the back, it looks like this. So we're transferring our weight. Our weight is on our left as the leader, right as the follower. Her left leg is free. And then as the leader, I invite her to turn. She turns, but as you can see, her back is still facing you. If she were to come out here, then she's not looking at me anymore. She's not looking at the wall. But she comes around and looks at me, or her chest looks at me, and then we step to the left together. Okay, we'll do it one more from the other side. So my weight is on my left foot, hers on my right, her left foot is free. I invite her, I'm like, please Vivian, step here. I then transfer my weight to my right foot. So my left foot is free, and we step. And then here, now, I allow Vivian to collect, and she is now facing this way. So this is the 180 that we were just doing. Yeah, so she's here, she's done the 180, and then we step together to the right. On this side, do the first bit as normal. So shoot the stepping left, and then Vivian collects. There's 180. I go to the right. So as the leader, it is essentially just this. And this is why I say we have it easier. But as the follower, they're doing the octos that we were doing earlier.
And they can help us by inviting us. So instead of just going, oh, I just decided, come with me. Just decided, come with me.
Yeah.
They're more, you go first, turn, I'll come with you. You go first, I'll come with you.
Yeah. So let's do it together. We have weight on my left, Vivian's right, so her left leg is free. I invite her, I change my weight, so my left leg is now free, her left leg is free. We step, Vivian does 180, I support her doing that, and then we go right. Vivian does 180, I support her, and now we go left. And we go right. And we go left. And we go right. And by all means, do it slowly. And then we can work on getting it a bit faster. So, together, we're transferring our weight, just as we were when we started walking. We then invite Vivian to go to the left. She steps forward with her left foot. I step side with my left foot. Vivian does 180. And we go. 180. And we go. Now, the last thing I'll say before I put on some music is, as a leader, your life is easy, yes, or easier right now. But try and make it, try and support the follower, but also try not to imagine you're, I don't know, on the CrossFit machine. Try not to use your arms. Try and use the embrace and imagine, as I said, you're holding a rock and then she can go. So if you look at my embrace from this side, that's very easy from this side, my arms aren't moving. If my arms are moving, it would look like this. Okay, and that's not what we want. We want subtle. So, because from the outside, it should look like, when we're dancing normally, it should look like I'm never moving my arms, right? Because if I were to move my arms, it would look like this. And that's nowhere near as nice.
Yeah.
So, leaders, support your followers when they're doing the 180. Followers, try and do 180. If you can, but no worries if you can't, because we appreciate it, it's difficult. And see how you get on.
I saw the fire in your eyes. I felt the fire burning, looking for your eyes. You feel me dancing on the drive. I walk the dance with the devil in disguise. You lost my mind. Come on, baby. Come on, baby. You're something new. You said you'd take me some time. Don't take me long, but it's my name. Come on,
Talking about around growing up here is so important. If I try to leave Vivian and I'm like this, she almost can't do anything. If I'm here, if I'm upright, I go, Vivian, I want you to go there. Vivian, I want you to go there. I'm saying it with authority. I'm saying it with assertiveness. So that helps. So now, as I said, I posed the question when we were walking around, how can you use these octos to get out of a tight space? Well, it's very simple. If we dance individually, or we walk individually, like we were before, if we're walking forward, you'll see that on any step, you're ready to do a forward octo. So if we step as a leader with our left foot first, we are, if we wanted to, ready to go into a forward octo. So normally I would walk. But this time, I'm ready to go in. And the same applies walking the other way. If I'm walking normally, now I decide, you know what, I want to do some octos. So, same applies for a follower.
Yeah, so let's say we're going, I need to think about that. We're going backwards, right? Every time I collect, he can lead me an ocho and go forward. He can lead me another ocho and go forward again. Then you can say, go back, right? So every time we have a free leg and a standing leg, a pivot can happen.
Yeah.
And then an ocho, because the ocho is the step after the pivot.
Yeah. Yeah, so just as we said, when we started with the ochos, we were change your weight, weight on one leg, and pivot. We can pivot in any time when we have weight on one leg, as Vivian said. So if we're going backwards as a follower, we can go connect, and then ready to pivot. We can go this way, or if we want, we can go this way. So I'll do it this way. I'll do it this way so you can see. So we've gone back. We've collected, and if we want, we can start going here, or we can start going here.
Yep.
And even in the backward step, if we break it down slowly, we're here, we transferred our weight. Oh, look where I am. I'm ready to go into a forward ocho. I've transferred my weight. Oh, forward ocho time. So now I've got another song. Think about once you get to the wall. So once you get to here and you can't go any further with your partner, think about going in a different direction through using pivots and the forward ocho. Okay, So I'll put on a song and give that a try. So yes, try and do a few steps and then a few watchos, and walk again, and then do a few watchos again, and then walk again, and do a few watchos.
No quiero nada, nada más. Quédame ver que frente a frente con la vida. Me moriré si me dejas, porque sin vos puedo saber vivir. Y no te pido más que eso.
While that's playing, I'm just going to explain quickly. You've done going from walking into the ocho. How do you get from the ocho into walking? Well, very simple. We're in the ochos. And then once we want to start, we go walking. Instead of turning Vivian 180, we turn her 90. And then we're ready to go. So we just don't come around as much. We come back to a neutral position.
Facing each other.
And I forgot to mention it, this is the third or fourth video for those who are watching at their own pace.
My lover's got humor, she's a giggle at a funeral, with everybody's disapproval, I should have worshipped her sooner. If the heavens ever did speak, she's the last true mouthpiece. Every Sunday's getting more bleak. Fresh poison each week. We were born sick, heard them say it. My church offers no absolutes. She tells me worship in the bedroom. Only heaven I accept you when I'm alone with you. I was born sick, but I love it. Let me to be well. I'm taking off the
Gancho in Spanish. Again, I know you all speak Spanish, but gancho means hook. So the reason it's called a hook is because we hook our legs. I'll show you. I can either hook Vivian's leg. You can't see from that angle. I can either hook Vivian's leg here, or Vivian can hook my leg here. So, we'll teach you both of those, and we'll start off with what we showed second, so where the follower is hooking the leader. And this is nothing crazy, it's literally using everything that we've done already.
Mm-hmm.
So, how do we start? Well, we do the ochos. So we start with the ochos. As the leaders, we just start going side to side.
And we're doing the hard work.
Exactly, the followers are doing the hard work. And now, when you can do it on either leg, but let's for the moment do it when she's going to the right, and we would normally step to the right as the leader. We give the intention for the follower to go forwards, so step normally like she would do in the ocho. And now you'll see, if Vivian stays there, you'll see that there's space in between her legs here. And that's where I'm going to put my leg. Now, I'm not going to come in with my chest because then I'm not Vivian off her axis. But what I am going to do is almost like I'm sitting on the toilet seat, sink down. Okay, so now my leg is in between Vivian's leg. And where I want to put it is pretty much slap bang in the middle. And now, in the embrace, so Vivian's still facing me, is I want to turn her back. So imagine she's going back, but now because she's going back, but my leg's in the way, what naturally happens is this. So the follower isn't going to go back
with her weight,
nor is she going to lift her foot up and then come back. I thought she would be like, oh, I want to go back. So I'm bringing my foot to come in. Oh, hang on a minute. Yeah, to collect. Oh, hang on a minute. I can't. And then I hook. Or she hooks. As the leader, I do turn my leg in slightly. So the back part of my leg is the one that she ganchos. And she hooks on, yeah. So show you again. We go from when she's going right. We give the intention to go. I sink down in. I then go to transfer her weight back and collect her feet. She can't because my leg's in the way. We gancho, my leg's turned out. And then we just let her come back and we collect.
Do you want to turn around so that we can see the other side?
So. We're going from this side, going right. I've come in, I've sank in. So as you can see, it's literally like I'm sitting on the toilet seat.
Whoop.
And then I lead her back to collect. She can't.
She hooks.
But look, our chests are still together. I'm not here. Our chests are still connected. But I've had to, as I said earlier, slightly turn my leg to give us that hook position. And you'll see we can both, well,
not for it.
I can. We can be on our own axis. So, and we hook. Now we can, as I said, either leave our foot on the floor as the leader, or we can hook as well. And if you want to be really fancy, we can then give it a push and go out. But health and safety probably won't advise that. But
don't try it at home.
Yeah. So do try it at home, but I didn't tell you to try it at home. So one more time. I've sat down. Well, I've sat and I've come in. I then go to lead her. We collect and we unwrap and we're back to begin. Now I'll show you how to exit slowly.
Before we show that, can we show the gunch again so that I can say something to the followers?
Let me do this.
Okay. So the intention he's giving me is, Vivian, please collect your leg, right? But his leg is here. So I'm not going to collect my leg and kill him. I'm going to collect my leg up to the point, because my leg is flexible, right, at the knee. Up to the point where my knee hooks with his, and then I'm gonna lift my leg without lifting my thigh. So it's not here, it's here. So my thigh is looking downwards. And then he has power to push it out and exit.
Yeah. So as I said, and as you said, it's not coming back and then your thigh going like this. The thigh is down. Oh, I can't go anymore. I lift from the knee. I'm collecting, can't go anymore, lift from the knee. Okay?
Yes.
So I'll show you just quickly how to get out, and we'll put some music on. So, you sat down, you've come in, you've ganchoed, we're at the knee, and then we remove our foot and come back to neutral. Show you again, we're about to gancho, we gancho, we then let her unravel and we come back to neutral. We let her unravel and we come back. Now that's one way. I'm going to show you another way. We need to be a bit quick. So, do exactly the same. And then we turn out and come back. Actually, no, let's do another one. Let's do another one. So we're in, we gancho, and we go to a side step. Okay, so we turned, gancho, kick out, come to neutral, and then we can do side. Okay, so we're going to put on a song and try doing it that direction. So we did it going as the followers right. Or to the followers left, to the leaders right. And then think about using different legs. So right then I was going in my right leg, think about going in with your left leg. Or think about doing it on the left-hand side instead of the right-hand side for the leader. Or the right-hand side, not the left-hand side for the follower. Okay. And this is the fifth video for those looking at, watching at home. I'm
realise perhaps we're being a bit mean and not showing you the easiest way of getting out of it. Just simply do the gancho, boom, and then go back to forward ochos.
Yeah.
Do the gancho, back to forward ochos. Gancho, she then unhooks, steps forward, and we return. So that's another way.
Yeah.
Pénsalo bien, antes de dar ese paso, que tal vez mañana paso, pueda retroceder. Pénsalo bien, ya que tanto te querimos, no has echado al olvido, tal vez por otro que.
Okay, so I'm not sure if anyone was watching us, but you would be able to see that you can do so many different things, so many possibilities. So we can go left, my left foot, boom. That's the follower stepping to the right, my left, sorry. My left foot. We can also go to the same direction with my right foot. We can also go the other way. Now my right foot, so going to the follower's left, my right. Or we can go with my left foot, boom. So there's so many different ways of doing the same move, but we've still got that hook movement, which is fundamental.
Which is from the lower part of the leg and not all the way from the thigh, from the hip.
Yeah. Okay, so I'm going to put another song now. Think about doing everything. So walking, changing your weight, ochos, ganchos.
Side steps.
Guess it's true, I'm not good at the moment, but I still need love, cause I'm just a man. These nights never seem to go to plan. I don't want you to leave, will you hold my hand? Oh, won't you stay with me? Cause you're all I need. You say there's nothing new to see, but darling, stay with me. Why am I so emotional? No, it's not a good look and some self-control. Deep down I know this never works. But you can make it with me so it doesn't hurt. Oh, won't you stay with me? Because you're thank you. Cause you're all I need.
Okay, so what we'll do now is the other gancho that we showed. And this is when, as a leader, I'm going to be gathering the follower. So.
They still lead that. We don't lead it ourselves.
Yeah, we still lead it. It's not automatic or decided. It's led and followed. Okay. So. We start off in the same position as always. And now, when we're on one leg, before we were pivoting the follower as a leader, and then we were going into our ochos. We're still going to do that, but we're going to do the right hand side first. Now, what we do is instead of going parallel to each other, I'm going to lead Vivian to my right hand side. So if we're talking this at 90 degrees to each other, I'm now going to leave Vivian at 45 degrees, so she comes across me. To show you the difference, this would be 90, this would be 45. And this side, this is 90, this is 45. Not sure you can see too well from that angle, but we'll do this one.
Mm-hmm.
90, 45.
So it's as if he's inviting me in the space that he has between his arm and his body.
Yeah.
Rather than sideways.
Yeah. So when we're in the embrace, if we have the point of contact here, here, if that is correct, it's like we've got a space here. So I'm leading her there. Boom. And what I have to make sure to avoid injury is that she has completely transferred her weight onto the leg that she's stepping with.
I'm stepping with my right now.
Yeah, so with her right, she stepped. And what I do is I come in here, so in between her legs, and then up. Now, I appreciate there might be some level of flexibility here. So just do as well as you can. So I'll show you from this side. So ochos, I lead her at 45 degrees. I don't worry if you have to move your feet, that's completely fine. I come in, I then go up. I come in, and I go up. And I come back, okay? In. Up.
And because I can feel him going in between my legs, I can help him have more space by bending my knee here on the leg that has the weight, right? So then I create more space than being here, I'm here. And he has space to do the gancho.
So yeah, just like we helped the followers by turning our leg in the original one, now, instead of being here, yeah. Okay, so one more time from a different angle now. We've done this one, we'll do this side. So, 45 degrees to my right. I come in, I come up, I come back. Okay, so I'm gonna put this on. And while you're doing that, you can by all means feel free to watch after 8:30 But this recording will go up on video on YouTube straight away, so you can rewatch whenever you want.
Mm-hmm.
Try thinking about, just as we did all the alternatives for the first move, try thinking about all the alternatives for the other one, or for this one. So I'm now coming in with my right leg on Vivian's right side. Yeah. Am I coming up? Can I go on my left? If I'm flexible enough to come up.
You can try.
You can try. What about on the left-hand side? I can go in and up there. Okay? So, experiment, see how it goes, and we'll put on some. And while we're doing this, don't just do this move. Do the walking again, do the octos again, do everything to remind yourself of what we did an hour and a half ago.
Mm-hmm.
The club isn't the best place to find the lovers, at the bar is where I go. Me and my friends at the table doing shots, drinking fast and then we talk slow. I'm over and start up a conversation with just me, and trust me, I'll give it just now. With my hands stop, put down the man on the jukebox, and then we start to dance. And now singing like, girl, you know I want your love. Your love was handmade for somebody like me. Come on now, follow my lead. I may be crazy, don't mind me. Say, boy, let's not talk too much. Grab on my waist and put that body on me. Come on now, follow my lead. Come on now, follow my lead. Mm-hmm. I'm in love with the shape of you. Push and pull like a magnet. Open my heart is falling to. I'm in love with your body. Last night you were in my room. Now I bet she smelled like you. At least I love you something grand. I'm in love with your body. Oh my. I'm in love with your body. Oh my. We came with our story, began with going out on our first day. You and me are 50, so we've been deep, but left your bag and I feel like a flick. So 5 hours and I was about sitting sour and her family's doing okay. And the taxi, kissing the taxi, tell the driver, make the radio play. And singing like, girl, you know I want your love. Your love was handy for somebody like me. Come on now, follow my lead. I may be crazy, but when we say, boy, let's not talk too much. Grab on my waist and put that body on me. Come on now, follow my lead. Come on now, follow my lead. I'm in love with the shape of you. Push and pull like a magnet. But my heart is falling to. I'm in love with your body. Last night you were in my room. Now I bet she felt like you were here. So I did something grand. I'm in love with your body. I'm in love with your body. I'm in love with your body.
Okay, hope you enjoyed that song. and it went okay dancing together. So coming towards the end of the lesson, first of all, I just wanted to thank you all once again for joining and donating and being part of the next 3 weeks. We really, really appreciate it. And I know everyone at Well With Friends appreciates it as well. Thank you for your time. I hope you've enjoyed it as much as we have. And I hope perhaps inspired some of you to start dance, whether that be tango or another form of dance. We love tango because it's a social dance. You have a great night out and fun with friends and dance at the same time. It's great exercise, it's great for socializing, and it's really good for the brain. So what we'll do now is we'll just recap everything that we taught today, and then we'll do a quick 30-second performance just to show you what tango can be like and will be like after you guys have done 3 weeks with us.
That's promising too much.
Yes, and for those of you that are perhaps watching at home at your own pace, thank you as well. And we'll show you now what we've done. So we'll start with tango embrace. We started with walking. We then went on to ochos. We then did a gancho for the follower. And we then did a gancho for the leader. So, show you from this side. Okay, so as I said at the beginning, the next 2 weeks are going to be doing a little bit of a choreography. We'll be using nothing more than the moves that we've done today, just making that into a choreography. So as you all join today, you're more than capable of doing the choreography that we do next week.
Yes.
So thank you everyone. And we will do a quick performance to a song, and might end the song a bit early because it's 4 minutes long. You know what? We'll tire ourselves out. We'll do the whole 4 minutes, and then we'll end the stream after. So, but if you need to go at 8:30, thanks again, and see you soon.
See you next week.
If the heavens ever did speak, she's the last through my feet. Every Sunday's getting more bleak, fresh more than each week. We were born sick, heard them say it. My church offers no absolutes, tells me worship in the bedroom. Only heaven I'll be sent to, where I'm alone with you. I was born sick, but I love and need to be with. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Take me to the showers, to back your door, at the sign of your life. I'll tell you my friends, and you can shout to me at night. I will be that breakfast there. Let me give you my hand. Take me to church, I'll worship like a dog. It was fine in your life. I'll tell you my sin, you'll be sober tonight. I believe that hope is never put down. Let me give you my hand. I'll take you on the good time. I love the good life. Keep the doors on my side. See the best sacrifice. In the whole city, it's all shining, so the day for the rain comes. There's a time looking high, but you're going to stay home. In the dark, it's dark and painful. Let it taste me, let it taste me. This is hungry work, take it to
Next week, guys. Thanks.
See ya.